Assalamu alaikum, greetings. Today we're carrying on with area. Okay, we've done perimeter, so now we're working on the area of the different shapes, right? So you remember I told you when you're doing a perimeter, we're actually checking the outer measurements of the shape. So it means we're actually walking around with a tape measure and measuring each shape on the perimeter and seeing how many meters can we add up all together, right? Now area is the part that is inside the shape. So we're measuring inside the shape how much of space is covered inside the shape. That is called the area. Like the area of a square plot or a house, this would be the area of your plot, right? If you have a rectangle, we're calculating all the space inside the rectangle, so that would be the area of the rectangle. If we have a triangle, we're calculating the space inside the triangle now. And the same thing with the circle, we're calculating how much of area inside the circle. So we have different formulas that you must have done in maths before as well. Okay, so we have the first one we have is a square, and you know in a square you can see that all four sides are equal and your area is equals to side times side. These are formulas that you have to learn if you've forgotten them, and you need to apply them to the questions, right? So side times side, so it's equals to side squared, or you can say side times side is the same thing. So in our example, you can see we've got 8 centimeters that is given to us, but because it's a square, we can see all four sides are equal. We can apply the area formula, which is side times side, 8 times 8, or 8 squared, and we get 64 centimeters squared, right? Because we're multiplying centimeters by centimeters, it becomes centimeters squared. Okay, then we're doing a rectangle. Now in a rectangle, remember, opposite sides are equal, so the breadth is equals to the breadth and the length is equals to the length, right? So then we have the area is equals to length times breadth. Very easy. Okay, so then here we've been given the breadth as 13, and now we're doing millimeters, and here we've given 25 as the length. So that two lines is telling you that these two are matching to each other. That is 25 millimeters. This side is matching to that side, so it can be, it's 13 millimeters. So how do we find the area of a rectangle? Area is equals to 25 times 13, which is length times the breadth, and we get 325 millimeters squared. Okay, so now remember, when you're calculating this formula or that formula, it has to be given to you in the question that the two opposite sides are equal, or they call the shape a rectangle, or in a square, all four sides are given to you equal like that with that sign there, or they tell you that the shape is a square, then you apply the appropriate formula. Then we're going to the triangle. Okay, so the triangle here, we're calculating area as half times the base. So what is the base of the triangle? It means the bottom part of the triangle. So we're saying half times the base, so you need the measurement of the base, multiplied by the perpendicular height. So what that means is you're working out the perpendicular height of any triangle. Look, this is a right angle triangle, so you know this is the height. But in this triangle here, if I draw the triangle without the diagram, now you want to know what must I multiply by height by, you have to, they have to give you the perpendicular height. So that's how you're working out the perpendicular height. So you're taking the value of the base, half times the base multiplied by the perpendicular height. So in this example here, you can see the base is 12 centimeters and the perpendicular height here is 2 centimeters. So my area would be half times the base, which is 12 centimeters, multiplied by the perpendicular height, which is 2 centimeters. If I multiply all that together, my answer is 12 centimeters squared. So remember, when we're doing perimeter, it's always in meters or centimeters, and when you're doing area, it's in centimeters, meters, or millimeters squared, right? So this is another example here where they've given you the base and there's the perpendicular height. Your area is half times the 3 times 4, which is equals to 6 millimeters squared. Okay, now the circle. The circle is the area inside the circle, so we're taking the formula of the area. It's equals to pi multiplied by the radius squared. Okay, you know pi is 3.142, but you're just punching it into your calculator. So what we're doing is, our area is, look, this is our radius, which is 18 centimeters. So we're saying pi multiplied by 18 centimeters squared. Be careful, you need to first square this number here and then multiply it by your pi value. Okay, so you take 18 squared, multiplying it by pi, and then you're coming up with 1801, centimeters squared. Okay, so now if they're telling you here, if the area of half a circle is asked, then you would say half times pi times radius squared. Same like how we did it in perimeter, okay? So what you're doing is you're taking the same formula, but now if you want to calculate half a circle, it would look like this, right? So then you're working out half a circle, you would say half times the formula. The full formula is pi times radius squared, you're multiplying it by half. And same thing, if you have a quarter circle, you would say if my area is equals to quarter times pi times my radius squared. Okay, so this half or the quarter is showing you the size of the circle. This is a full one. We're saying 1 multiplied by that. We don't say the 1. Here for a half or a semicircle, you would say half times the formula. Or for a quarter circle, you would say quarter times the formula. Now let's go through.